Yeah. We are back. Eagles are in the playoffs. Cowboys are not. So y'all know how my weekend went. Very well. Such a great present after going broke for Christmas and making sure my kids had an excellent Christmas. I can't wait for these holidays to be over with so I can actually have a little money in my pocket, because as of now, I'm just buying groceries and need necessities. Anything I need that's necessary is what I can get. Can't get wants right now. Not right now, at least. But I got what I wanted. Cowboys are out. Eagles are in. Happy New Year. In the year 2020 and beyond, for me, going to go through a lot of changes. A lot of very important changes that I think are going to improve me as a person and just overall as a father, as a human being in general. I gotta unlearn. I have been unlearning. I ain't gonna say I gotta unlearn. I've been unlearning all the BS that I was taught. And this year in particular, you know, last year, I could take it back even further than that. 3 years ago, I realized that I wasn't in control of my alcohol. I started working on my sobriety. It's been a fight for the past 3 years, going on 4. I did very well this year until the summertime. Well, the end of the summer. End of the summertime, got reckless, fell off the wagon, fell apart, just everything fell apart. But I wasn't happy though. You know, I knew that it's a lot that was going on in my personal life that I thought was going to happen that didn't happen. And when it didn't happen, that's when I kind of spiraled out of control and kind of fell off the wagon. But I got back on it. I got back on it, started going to counseling. And these past 6 months, or 5 or 6 months, I've been back on track. So this year in particular, for sure, I need to do the whole calendar year, 365 days of sobriety. I didn't do it this year. I was supposed to do it this year, but just this year was weird, man. It started off so fire. Like, my channel hadn't grew. I hadn't got to 12,000 subscribers. Shit was moving. And then I got terminated. And that was the first blow. I originally fell off the wagon then. First blow, because I was like, man, I don't even know if I want to continue to do this. Because I also had got my job, my old job back too. It literally, this is how it happens. Literally got my channel terminated. Lost my source of income. Got an email from my old job to get the job back. And started working. So that money kept me afloat while I was rebuilding my YouTube channel. And I was also negotiating my job offer while I was working. I told them what I wanted. They didn't give it to me. So I quit. But I hadn't started rebuilding my channel. So it wasn't like they was paying me so much money more than I was doing on YouTube. So why, and then it's way harder work. So why would I work harder for the same amount of money that I could make from home? That's just, the pros didn't outweigh the cons for me. So I quit and just went lock back in and focus on my channel. Now my channel is back up to 4,000, going on 5,000. We good. And then I created this channel right here for my podcast, which I haven't been consistent with, but 2020 definitely going to be way more consistent with the podcast episodes and just material on this channel in particular. It's just hard, you know. I might look into getting some help. That way, you know, I won't have to do everything by myself. Might get, like, my nephew or my niece or something to help me out through, like, go through emails, send me lists. I don't know. Editing videos, I don't have the income to be paying nobody to edit my videos, so I have to edit my videos myself. But I think I need to, this year too, 2020, I think I want to, on my other channel, I think I want to get better equipment, because I definitely need another laptop. I definitely need a real microphone. It's a lot of equipment that I need to improve on this year too that I will. But it's also a lot of things that I got going on personally, because I don't have a vehicle. Working on that too. Gonna get a vehicle. So I have a lot of goals in mind. I just gotta work on them. 2020 is gonna be different. I think it's gonna be different for other people than it will be for me. Because this year I'm definitely gonna be more selfish in my actions. You know, I sacrifice a lot, you know, for my kids. I make a lot of my decisions based on the location and how will it affect my kids. But it's to the point where now that's been holding me back. And I know that's been holding me back. I just been in denial, because being a father, I hold my hat on that so heavily. And I know that's like one of the few things that I've always been, you know, I was an alcoholic. I was a good basketball player. Could have went to the NBA. Never followed through on that. I could have been a good artist. Never followed through on that. The few things that I followed through on is this YouTube channel and being a parent. But like I said, I think this year I'm going to focus on getting myself in a position where I'm going to be financially stable. I am stable as a parent when it comes to spending time with them and playing with them and just being there for them. But financially, I'm not in the position I'm in. I want to be in. I can't do the things that I really want to do with them. So this year, I'm going to work towards that. But outside of my own 2020 goals, y'all let me know in the comments what's y'all plans for 2020 and beyond, this next decade that's coming up. I didn't take advantage of the last decade like I should have. I was in the position too, but just was too young and immature to do that. Now that I know better, I'm going to do better. But besides all that, my Eagles made it to the playoffs. This basketball season has been interesting. The Lakers can't get past the Clippers. They beat up on everybody but them. And that's not good for LeBron, because if you can't beat them now, when they get better with team chemistry and it comes to the playoffs with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, and they don't even play together like that, and y'all can't beat them, y'all ain't making it past that Western Conference. Oh, and I got to walk back my Houston Rockets. It's not working. I thought it was going to work. I thought Westbrook, well, I ain't even blame that on Westbrook. I thought Harden was going to change his game to try to get a championship. He did not change his game at all. He did not change his game. I think he might have got worse. I think it's worse than it was last year. So yeah, that didn't work. I was wrong. But that's it, man. Happy New Year's. You know, that's why I ain't been record no podcast episodes because I just been so busy on the other channel, my Fish Out of Water series channel, with my reactions and knocking down donation lists and requests and spending time with my family. I haven't even been watching movies or TV shows. I haven't watched a TV show since Blacklist season was over with. Since that season finale, I haven't watched any TV shows. Oh, I watched Six Underground. Six Underground was good. A lot of action. A lot of disgusting action scenes. Like, a lot. But, great action movie. They stuck to the action. The story was cool. A lot of action. But that's like the last thing I watched. And I never did a review for it just because I didn't have the time to. Between spending time with my kids and my family for Christmas and the holidays and recording videos, I don't really have time to do anything at all. Unless I just be laying down watching TV while I'm editing videos, and then I haven't been doing that because I also been working my Instagram and my Twitter. So I'm so hands-on with everything I do, I rarely find some kind of free time, which is good though for somebody like me who struggles with sobriety, because too much free time for me means I might fall off the wagon. Because I might start thinking about all kind of BS that I don't need to be thinking about. Get down on myself and all that. But that's neither here nor there, man. Like I said, Happy New Year's to everybody. I hope everybody 2020 is blessed and highly favored. Everybody get their goals completed. I know I'm going to work on mine heavily. Like I said, let me know in the comments what y'all got planned for 2020 and beyond, man. I got a lot of things planned. I just got to execute it. And y'all going to see it. Appreciate y'all listening. Peace.